at phones that we use today in probably America and Europe, the kind of data we are using, basic applications like Facebook and all those things, I don't think it's going to be that relevant to a villager and farmer. So when you look at that, we need to figure out how to make technology that is going to use things like network bandwidth a lot more efficiently, things that is going to be applicable to illiterate or semi-literate person. So some of these technologies has to be drastically different from what we are developing today. So this I think there's a lot of interest in trying to figure out what they are and what different technologies we need to develop, so that has a very direct application to the developing world. About 10 years ago, when internet was coming up, but in a lot of developing country settings, people had access to email. But they didn't have access to internet, because internet means you had to have continuous connectivity. It was very expensive. So we developed a system where you can browse the web just using email. So it almost looks like you have a web browser. So this got used in a lot of schools where during daytime, the phone line is used by the principal. But at night, the phone line can be used to download and upload information for a couple of hours. And so what these schools did was, in during daytime, the students were able to go and submit what they want to look at, but they won't get it immediately. They submit it, and then our system sent it through email. And the next morning when the students went to the computer, that information was available. So they were able to use a system using email to basically access information otherwise they wouldn't have access to. These days it's not that important, because most schools and also getting internet access. So if you have email right now, people have internet access. Okay. So this is one area where by changing technology, we were able to give access to people.